the singleton to be turned swift. Okay, first three imps to Sweden, and on to board 18. Where north-south have a game. Four spades, any problems there? Indeed, when spades are 4-1. Two clubs, a heart, and a spade, if they take their tricks. And, no matter who declarer is, the defender will have a natural club lead. Yeah, four spades down, one in the other room, looks normal. How many diamonds does he have when he opens the diamond in his precision, relay precision system? One, two?
Just a moment.
None?
No. Two, it says here.
Yeah. And I'll just route one diamond, 11-15, 2+.
Stay with the foul. That way I just don't have to keep going to the browser and looking up the system. Excellent.
So this is part of two-way check back, Damon. A game-forcing relay here. Device knows they have a fit, unless partner is 2-2 in the majors. Can happen, but also unlikely. So he'll investigate. And South will give the cheapest information he can, and that is three spades. And it really should go down. I mean, East has a normal queen of club. So as long as they take the two club tricks, nothing bad can happen for the defense. Well, you may argue, well, declarer can pick up the trump suit. Absolutely right, and Jip would probably do that. I don't click on Jip, but if you do, Jip will probably tell you that this can be made. But remember, Jip is looking at all four hands. Not only do you need space 4-1, you only need a second entry for the next finesse. Maybe you don't. But if you do, you could get there, because you can rough a heart eventually. No problems. He'll go down.
Stake.
All five.
Spades. I guess he can't make it if we're safe. recording this time.
Could you pop all five? Do you have? I guess. Well.
I don't think you can.
No.
Maybe you can coup it. Spade to the king, spade back. No, I don't think you can pick it up. All right, we'll let him off.
Spades, just a spade opening. No. So much for Levinson. Sometimes you have hands where you can natural two no trumps. And then you just have to go.
Nevertheless, I think Levinsohl after Palmer doubles a week two is a good idea. I think it comes in pretty handy. You bid two no trumps with a really weak hand. So when you bid a suit at the three level, it shows some values, typically about 8 to 11 points. So it's worth it, and this hand is no exception, despite the slightly limited values, combined 24 count, this three no trump contract's going to make. Without a huge amount of difficulty, just a little bit of luck. The Clara holds up the spade and South doesn't have an entry as long as, well, it'll need the heart finesse and the ace of diamonds with North. And then there's eight tricks, there's nine tricks.
Now, Roy Welland did against five down in the Germany match against France. 10 inch.
Great stuff. Roland, do you know a bit help there, like at this table?
No info. All I can say is lead, nine of clubs, 10 imps. Ah, four clubs, five, Sabina. Right. Yes, she did bid four clubs. So, you know, he dared not overrule her, you see. At least he would win the post-mortem if it turned out to be wrong. Why did you need a top spade, partner? That would have defeated the contract. Well, I thought you wanted a club lead.
Declare what happens. The ace of hearts. South has a singleton king of hearts.
your hand. Was in a or PO so for me. Swedish names, because them. Didn't I? Oh, it wasn't you.
Yeah. I don't have use.
Well, not anymore when I tell you that the W in Van is pronounced, for a start, and Sylvan. You'd stress the second syllable.
So this Declare a play was different because they hadn't threatened the spades. So Declare is, I guess, just taking a double finesse in hearts. He feels like he's in good shape. He just needs one of the heart honours with North.
Well, they don't clear a suit, they usually don't have an entry. So the King of Hearts is hardly with South.
Still, I would have been 100% safe just in case, but yes, the point's well taken. But it certainly doesn't apply here. This is a completely different scenario. And I'm sure that Sylvan was quite right to just take the two finesses in hearts. I do think that the Dutch West, the Ace of Hearts, and the spades were cleared.
Okay, always. Flat. You know, Monaco could also leap both and forth, right? Who had a 9-0 France behind by 10 against Germany. I'm asked about the qualification from the women's. It's the same in all three categories. The top six will qualify. Top seven if France is among the top six. And it won't be for the Bermuda Bowl, obviously, in the women's. It will be the Venice Cup and the Seniors Bowl.
This contractor on the lead. was to Wilson or likely to play low from dummy, in which case North will play low.
Yep. But let's see, can they defeat it even if they take a rough? That's two tricks. And a diamond is, well, could the eight of spades come into play? No, not if they take a rough. Then if you just play a spade to the queen, the 10 will fall and you have a finesse against the king eight.
Yes, I think if this is covered and North wins it and plays one back and it declare it ducks it, the contract will make, as you describe. But that doesn't seem like a very likely set of plays to me. Having said that, it's probably exactly what's going to happen. It's time the prediction.
Yeah.
Play the spade jack. Isn't he's got two clubs.
Well, it would be the same, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be beatable, does it? It's the cleric can just draw trumps and bully his way to getting one more club trick. And the defence don't quite have the timing to get busy in diamonds. So here a heart back to the ace, draw the last two trumps, and now play on diamonds.
Diamonds? Clubs.
Sorry. Play on clubs.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's quite hopeful that he can make no. I mean, South would often have the 10 of clubs after the Jack League.
Well, he better not try to play for the over trick. Having drawn the trumps, I think he should just take his contract and don't come back to your hand at this point. Just play the clubs out from dummy. That's the sure way to 9 to 10 tricks.
Exactly. Would have been different at match points. I'm asked about our matches for the last round. I can't tell you. We decided till they know which matches will be in for medals and qualification stuff. So sorry, Bill, you were going to say something.
Yes, Vrung played very well to play that Jack of Spades. If he'd played the Two of Spades to the Queen, I think that means that South has a natural spade trick. It was by no means obvious to play the Jack being losing. Suppose South had the singleton king, then he would have looked foolish.
Did the other table mark scored a spade trick? The contract is on its way down.
Well, he did risk the half, and he would have gone down. Well, he's still in some trouble here, is he?
No, because North is down to one diamond. Well, that's extremely lucky. North has a singles and queen of diamonds now. So he can't play another when he gets in with the second club.
Well, it was a little dangerous, but it's all right. I mean, he's developed a heart trick for North, but of course the loser just gets thrown away. Maybe it was safe. Safe-ish. I don't think it was completely safe. I think if North had started with five hearts, then it would have been extremely unsafe.
Yeah. So the contract is going down at the other table. I know that for sure, with five cards remaining. So that should be 12 imps to Sweden. And they have overtaken the Netherlands now and are in second place.
So I wonder if the Clara just did play a spade to the queen and develop a spade loser that way.
Let's see when the result is in. How strong are we when we open to now? Could be an upgrade, this. 19, 3 tens, and a 9.
Yep, the card says 20-21.
Yes, but it is worth an upgrade, isn't it? Not nice intermediate cards. That's fine.
Yep, the two of spades led to the queen, and that's that. That gives South a spade winner. So my sympathies to the Dutch declarer. It didn't look totally obvious to play the jack of spades.
Well, this is the point where spectators can walk that turtle, if they like, and still be back before this hand is complete. This will take time, I promise you.
Oh, what's the lead? A diamond lead might shorten it a bit. A diamond lead, declarer has got a claimer. He's got two diamonds, three clubs, there's five, three spades, there's eight. An easy path to a ninth trick in hearts.
Yeah. So what is three clubs?
A spade or what's three clubs? Oh. And this, I imagine, will be Muppet Stamen, so I'm guessing the three hearts denied a four or five card major. Let me check.
Point made by Hans Jota from Sweden, the former Swedish star, that when Vrang actually advanced the Jack of Spades, Bill. Now, if he thinks that the Jack of Clubs is a singleton, then Spades could easily and perhaps are more likely to be 4-1. At least that's the point. Do you buy it?
Well, I certainly buy that it's a point. But it does seem to me that the jack is a reasonable play. Look, let's have a look at it. Let's see if we can look at it logically. If If spades are 3-2, it probably doesn't matter which one he plays. Well, no, that's not true. I'm almost tempted to go off to a piece of software and find out what the best play is.
Right, so now it won't take as long as I predicted on this lead, obviously. Now, if you get a spade lead, you see, you also kill the entry to the heart in dummy. You have to let the opponents in, and they continue spades. And you can't get to the queen of hearts. In fact, two heart tricks, queen 8. At the other table, it got a heart lead.
So the suit play program says that the Jack of Spades is the best play for four tricks. So hold yourself to one loser. Now the problem here is whether you do have one loser. If clubs are short, sorry, let me say this again. If the clubs are short suit lead, Jack X or Jack Singleton, then you need to actually play the spades for no losers. In which case, I think it would be correct to play a low spade.
Despite the 4-1 club break?
Alright, well look, I'll put the vacant spaces information into the program, Roland.
No, Al. Question. By the way. No, it's a point.
The program's clear cut. It says you should lead the jack, but irrespective of the of what you know about.
Wow. So Rank played it well. Let's applaud him.
Yeah. You should applaud him. Great play. By the actual percentages. Whether he knew that or went on a bit of a gut feel, we don't know. Of course, if it goes Jack, King, Ace, which it didn't, then you come back to your hand and you've got to decide whether to play the 9 or the 2. Because there now could be a... assuming that it's gone Jack, King, Ace, low card. You've got some further options of how to pick up the suit. But leading the Jack is the best way to pick up that suit for no losers, which I think is what East was trying to do.
Yes. Although the Jack of Clubs could be from some length, like Jack 10, and then he would only have one club loser. He didn't know he had two club losers.
Yes, but if he's only got one club loser, then he can afford to lose the spade, and the jack really only fails if there's a singleton king there somewhere. So it's got good chances anyway. It only fails in the sense that it develops two spade losers for you if somebody's got the singleton king.
Most interesting board. And so it's this. Now east-west can't make anything in spades, but north-south in a club contract can suddenly make a game. The question is, can they make a slam? The answer is, they can. Six clubs.
Yeah. Six clubs indeed. Six diamonds is tempting, but I think a trump lead might cause a problem. But you've got a fallback position in hearts, so maybe six diamonds is okay as well. So this is a good hand to watch. Let's see what happens. They've got themselves a little bit of preemption there. Good bid from Sylvain.
Remember, absolute max.
He's just responding, and I was going to. That's an interesting bit.
Minus.
So negative double, right. That's a very strong hand. I was just thinking he might just simply bid four diamonds and see what happens.
Well, he did well to double, because if he bids four diamonds, you can forget about the club slam.
It's very hard for them because a great hand and small spade to any same contract. And South does have the club control, but the heart spade control, but he doesn't realise that North has such a monster.
No. Well, North couldn't do more. Four diamonds, Q. There were partners for hard cue. He had to bid five clubs without the spade control. And it was difficult for South to picture that powerhouse opposite.
You'd think these were cue bids. I read them as possibly natural bids.
Do you? Four diamonds would have been natural over three spades.
Well, that takes me around to the end of the circle. Why didn't he bid four diamonds? Why didn't he bid four diamonds? I mean, if four diamonds is a Q and four hearts is a Q, North bids five, but he doesn't have spade control. Isn't it, doesn't South have to bid six because he does have spade control? I think they were bidding naturally here.
Yeah, it makes sense because, I mean, obviously North must have a big hand when he Q bids four diamonds, if that is a Q bid, right? And then he has to bid five clubs without the spade. spade control, so maybe you should race to 6 when you have the spade control. Oh, you see, is there some ambiguity regarding the 4 hard bit? Could it be natural, so offering an alternative? Interesting. We'll have to ask the players.
Yeah, look, I don't think this is solvable. I mean, even if North had bid 4 diamonds natural, then what can South do other than just go back to 4 hearts? He doesn't really have primary diamond support. He's got a 6-card heart suit. And then North is not really in the know. 4 hearts is... 4 hearts might not even make. I mean, this could be worse for the Dutch. At least they're going to make a contract.
They're still playing 21 in the other room, but I'll let you know how they bid when they get to 22.
Yes, they've got half a loaf here. They've missed a slam, but at least they've made a game. And I can see scenarios, perhaps not particularly likely ones, where North-South will get to 4 hearts, and that contract's down. It's got 3 heart losers in the Ace of Spades. Now, West shape on the hand before. Identical.
Now, this is on West hand. 3 loose. Well, it could be 2 diamonds because that has a strong diamond included. So that's what he chooses. So it's a multi, either weak in a major or strong with diamonds. And again, you need to get to your second suit, clubs. 6 clubs. Well, 6 clubs, yeah. Because of this club position, it's not a contract you'd like to be in.
No. Perhaps 3 no trumps would be probably a reasonable spot, and it's certainly good for 8 tricks.
Yeah. So 3 clubs confirms the strong diamond hand with a club side suit. Well. 12 imps back to the Netherlands. Bill, will you tell us how, why?
And when? Well, this was this 3 no trumps where the top diamond lead at this table just handed the clearer the contract on a plate. At the other table, the Dutch West led a heart, which didn't seem all that brilliant, but apparently it worked. Let's have a look. He led a heart because his partner had bid him.
In fact, this is a horrible slam. Not only do you need diamonds, five clubs is plenty. On 10-22, the sweet bit to five. One hearts, three spades from west. North bit clubs, race to five. He doubled. South bit four clubs, and north just raced to five. Because he didn't have a spade control. He could have bid four diamonds, of course. Until the declarer misplayed the contract at the other table, Bill, in 3-0.
Well, I was looking at the play, and I would say that that is a severe overbid. It's a very tricky position that the Swedish declarer found him in, and I think it would be very strong language to say he misplayed us.
Yeah.
I would go a little kinder and say he misguessed us.
Okay. Just quoting, because I haven't been through the play.
Well, I have, and it really follows the lines that we were chatting about, Roland, and that was that they're short of entries to the dummy, and the defence did get around to attacking the spade suit, and that gave declarer serious problems of communications, which he didn't solve. He essentially played for clubs to be 4-3, and when they weren't, down he went. The specs were me.
Okay, maybe he'll send you a private message. Me. In the head shop, just have set up a diamond trick.
Yeah, well. He's wrong. He could have set up a diamond trick, but that did not give him nine tricks, because what was going to happen is if he'd set up a diamond trick, the defence was going to set up a spade to play the spades, put him in dummy for the last time, and he would have had no solution. He would have had eight tricks if he'd set up a diamond trick, but not nine.
Looking good behind by the same time. Area. It would be a surprise if qualified could be poked, could be
Israel. Yes, well, there's still 13 teams in striking distance of the top seven. The last 16 boards are going to be a white-knuckle job.
And you'll be fast asleep by then, won't you?
Yeah, it's just not quite important enough for me to watch Roland.
Well, at least it's half an hour early. So, 23:30 start. No pressure, Bill. No pressure. But I'm happy to do one with you, if you're up to it.
Okay, I'll think about it. What's happening here? Is he making this thing? Ooh, what about a heart and a club? Low heart from south to his king, and then the third round of clubs, and there's a diamond loser.
That's right.
This is exciting. Maybe we should have been paying more attention.
No, we're paying attention now. Could declare I have made it legitimately. Well, if he had taken a roughing finesse rather than a direct finesse in diamonds, then he would have made.
Yes, he's tried to drop the diamonds. Possibly influenced by that pop-up of a club honour on the first round. Is this analyzable by Muller? That's some ones and secondary clubs. So we know Clara has the king left. So that would suggest a stiff heart.
Yeah, and that's unlikely to be the king. Why wouldn't Clara play the king of hearts early in that case? Setting up the Queen Jack.
Well, that's what Muller is mulling around in his head. If I play a low half here, could I be embarrassed by Declara winning the Singleton King? And when the Ace of Hearts was the setting trick, for example, my partner having the Ten of Clubs.
True. Very difficult. It will take a while. It should take a while for everyone. But Muller isn't fast, we know that. So he'll take his time. We can see it now that South did indeed underlead his hearts for down one.
Yes, almost identical position, and the Swedish South played the low heart for the killing club return.
great board again. We have so many. Cut any more into the bulletin. There's one more bulletin, yes, but that's just with the presentations. So the EBS is at the moment, so for the pages to see. Wow. Bill? Bill is away.
I'm here. Unimpressed. I thought he would. I mean, all the logic is there, and these guys are like computers in many ways. So as soon as he started taking his time, I sort of felt, yeah, he would get this right.
Good result for Sweden here. It's a cold six diamonds, I agree. Still have to bid it. But, you know, no starting with a strong club, I suppose. No. One no. How strong, Bill? Is that 15-17? Or 14-16?
15-17, it says.
Right. So obviously South will do something. Well, they didn't have as much room in the other room, because North did open a strong club, and East overcalls three spades, double by South. Four spades from West. Pass back to Uppmark. And he bid what he thought he could make. What he hoped he could make. Six diamonds.
Yep, went the Ackle route. Think, did what you think you can make. Here it looks. It looks like and followed by.
Yes, that's certainly an option we can follow. I would bid likewise. Three diamonds forcing with longer diamonds than a major. Now we need Al again. Hearts and three spades. in 76.
And it makes sense.
No. Amazing. Is this key card ask? Or what? Or is it a cue?
Three hearts asked for shortness, three spades showed it, four clubs, maybe a cubit. That's certainly what South wants to hear about.
Oh, not sure about four clubs. So you learn something here, Al. Take note. In fact, I don't think he'll learn anything, because he still won't know what four clubs is. That if they bid a slam, it's probably a cubit.
I don't entirely think Opener has taken control. I think they're still having a cooperative auction. I mean, certainly took control in terms of asking about the shortage. And then he could have warned Partner off with a three-no trump bid if the shortage had been opposite, you know, King-Queen or something like that. Four hearts might be kicked back Blackwood, or it might be a Q-bid.
Yeah. If it is kicked back, perhaps you could use four diamonds as the same. Even more economical.
Yeah, sort of a minor wood thing.
Does it make sense?
Could be 14:30. No. One step, two step response.
No, because North has two.
He's got two. No, we're off, aren't we? Okay, so it's not kick black. Could be Blackwood.
No.
Four no trumps. What do you think, Roland?
I think four hearts is a cubit now.
Yeah, no, I understand. And so four no Blackwood?
Yeah, I think so. Why not? Does this
zero
make
three?
Sense? Yes. 0-3. That would make sense. Yeah, there's a Dutch player who knows the system in and out. I forget his last name. I think the system, so he should certainly know what all this means. I can't remember his last name. It is Rob something. He's been living in England for many years now. Oh, Rob Helle. Yes, Rob Helle. That's the name. Absolutely. I'm thinking of Rob Helle. Yeah, he knows the system.
Yes, don't know about the end of the auction. Possibly five diamonds, or, I mean, I think if it's a three key card response, then clearly five diamonds is not going to get passed. Perhaps he was leaving room for his partner to cubit the King of Hearts or something like that. Unclear.
So maybe when a response is ambiguous, you sign off in the trump suit and ask partner to bid on if he has three rather than zero. If you make that a habit, you can do it every time. Because obviously, three key cards must be enough.
Yeah, I've seen too many accidents along those lines, and personally, I don't do it. I feel that we should know enough that to know whether partner's got three or zero. So here, for example, how could partner possibly have no key cards? It's completely impossible. So, I don't know. Anyway, they're in the perfect contract, so no complaints.
So 9/11 non-vulnerable in first, second, third.
Bad result for the Netherlands table. They took adequate penalty.
But could it? Did they not miss? Let's see, 2, 4, 5, and sure, he should have beat them. I mean, a diamond rough is the third, isn't it? Did I miss?
Yeah, no, you're right. They let a trump, so. He just followed his nose and led his ace-king suit. They could indeed have taken it three off.
In which case, it wouldn't have been that bad. That's true.
Yeah, four hearts. I guess the double show was intended to show cards. Sorry, it looks like it was taken as showing hearts.
Yeah. But could they not survive the 4-3 fit? I think so, but they're bidding on. I don't think they can get to clubs now, can they? I mean, as far as West is concerned, they're in hearts. Four spades must be a cue for hearts.
Well, the mini no trump has caused chaos here. Absolute chaos. Of course, you can see what Sylvain's thinking. He's got this prime, pure 15 count, and his partner's made a penalty double at one no trump.
Yes, but even if they can stop in five clubs, isn't that down, or can he eliminate and throw North in at some point to only lose one hard trick when clubs are 2-2?
You're talking about six clubs, right?
Sorry, six clubs, obviously. Yeah, five clubs will make. But how do they get there? Five hearts, however. Will West take this as natural? Phew-ah. Why did partner?
Unlikely.
Yeah, on the other hand, why didn't partner Blackwood rather than five clubs?
Because he doesn't have diamond control. I mean, I can see where this is going. If there's been a misunderstanding, and East thinks West has got hearts, and West thinks East has got a long suit of hearts because he hasn't actually shown them, then this auction makes some level of sense. They're cubiting.
If they get out in five hearts, they should make. They'll only lose two hearts, as it is. That would be extremely lucky.
So we got, does it make on a spade lead? Well, suppose they just lead spades. Win the ace, well, what are you going to do?
Now, see what you mean. Can you just give up a hard play, a low heart from hand? North must go up. Can he bother you now? Play another spade?
Yeah, that's a bother. That's a big bother.
No. Yeah, I'm asked if I and Bill are interested in rugby. Well, I'm not. I don't know about Bill. Because England has just won the third match in the Test series against Australia. And now leading 3-0, unassailable lead. So I shouldn't have told you, Bill. Sorry.
Yeah, I have limited interest. If you know Australia, you'll find that it's actually partitioned. There are certain areas that are particularly uninterested in rugby, and that's where I am. But that test series was actually in Australia as well, if I've got this right, Roland. In which
Yes.
case it's sort of nationalistic throat-slitting time for Australia. But we'll carry on. I'm more
Yeah.
interested in what West's bid is going to be right now.
Are you really? Okay. But cricket, I mean, man living in
Oh,
Melbourne with the
we all like cricket,
MCG,
yes.
yeah, you must love the cricket. What's the capacity? Is it 100,000? 95?
It's almost 100,000. They rebuilt a lot of stands, so the highest attendance, which was to a football match, was 121,000 back in 1970. But the capacity has gone down actually. Here they are. They've cubited their way up to some god-awful contract, and I think they've got to the point of a minus here. It's pretty clear to me West thinks they were bidding for hearts, so he confirms the diamond queue and then raises to slam.
Well, this hand I can analyze.
Well done.
Earn any points for that?
Well, yes, there's always points to be had, but there's micro points. But my theory is that I don't think five hearts can make on a spade lead. press Gib to discover that I was wrong. It can make, so a spade lead is handleable somehow.
Right.
Oh, I see how. You win the spade and play a low heart, and the queen wins, and they play another spade, and you rough it. Now you play another low heart. If they play a third spade, you rough that, cross the dummy's ace of diamonds, and draw the last trump, discarding from your hand. A sort of a dummy reversal.
Mm-hmm. On the previous hand, Muller's three diamonds, I'm told, the six diamond hand, promised four hearts and five plus diamonds, and a shortage. So the three hearts asked for the shortage. Not if he had one, but where it was. I'm also told that Rob Helen moved to Poland a couple of years ago, and that the Tarson system, has moved on since Rob, and that Steve Green from England introduced the system to them several years ago. Thanks for the info. Very useful. Thank you.
I reckon it's because he's trying to make it. He'll run this at this point. We had a horrendous error. Passing the king from king. And now he...
I'm told that Italy made six clubs after defensive slip. And that England went down in the same contract at the other table.
Gosh, what will David Bird be saying?
Oh, yes, he's there, commentating with Mark Horton. Dear, do you think they left the table?
My guess is that David will be making some very acidic comments about the English play.
Yes, at both tables. I mean, not only the missed defense, but also how can you bid to slam a no play slam?
This must be a pretty deadly position for England. They must be slipping out of contention if this is what's happening. And conversely, Italy must be slipping into contention again.
Absolutely. Italy leading 44-0. Oh dear. That's for Bill to answer. This is a pretty straightforward four-spade contract. So, Bill, I know Bill has played both, so he is the right man to reply. I played both. But let's hear Bill's view. I want to know more about four-card versus five-card majors. Pros and cons. What's your opinion?
Well, my opinion is that there are pros and cons. Does he want to know what they are? So the question is this. What do you think about the minors? because if you sniff at the miners and feel that it's not all that important to get to miner suit contracts, then go ahead and play five-card majors, because five-card majors looks after the majors very nicely. You find your fits, you find your 4-4 fits, you find your 5-3 fits all very comfortably. But your minor suit openings are damaged in that they no longer show the suit. You know, two clubs, three clubs, that's two or three diamonds, whatever. So, to me, that's the basic pros and cons. It's the minors versus the majors. And I'm sure it's cyclical to a degree, but right now in the world, there's a heavy preference for opening five-card majors.
Yes. I'd like to add one thing here. If you play four-card majors, you get the major in right away, and you discover if you have a 4-4 fit right away without having to open one of the minor first, and maybe someone will preempt or whatever. Major before minor, one heart, four plus hearts. At least your partner knows that already. He doesn't know anything if you open one club or one diamond. Al Hollander recommends that we read the Bridge World articles from the 1960s, where there was a discussion.
Yeah, look, let me put a different perspective on it, a theory of mine. You should play both. You should play one and you should play the other. And you have more fun that way when you move around your system a little bit and try different things. It's a change is as good as a holiday in many ways. So either method can clearly work well. Work well on many hands, work poorly on other hands. No, there's no absolutes about this. So I would recommend that people find a like-minded partner and experiment with different approaches to bidding. That's a big part of the fun of the game.
Mm-hmm. I don't mind four-card majors, I have to say. I don't mind four-card majors with canopies, even. Then I get my major in right away. But I agree with you, Bill, that it's mainstream now, well, more or less, now to play five-card majors, and I think that is the future of natural systems, five-card majors. Well, that slam hand on board 25, until he met, I'm told, was a quote by David Bird. It's wonderful to see a world-class player going down. It's a reasonable contract. How is six clubs a reasonable contract? Pray tell.
Well, it's not, but perhaps he's been misquoted a little, because it is to a degree reasonable to get there. It's a tempting set of cards. It's the nine of hearts away from a good contract, from a 75% contract or so. But without the nine of hearts, it was, of course, a very poor contract.
Yeah, but even with the nine of hearts, you would like clubs to be 2-2.
Yes, a mere detail, Roland, but an absolutely accurate one. The 9.5 certainly bumps you up past 50%, but perhaps it doesn't get you all the way to 75% because of the problems of what to do with the fourth heart.
lot to say, of course, about the flat.
Yep, I mean, three winners for the fence, but awkward for them to take.
Norway has overtaken Hungary now, crucial seventh place now. All very interesting. Wow, I think one of Trump is a game forcing relay. You're telling me.
Absolutely correct. Game forcing relay is what the card says.
Yeah, and I'm often asked when we have relay processionists on ViewGraph, what do they do with a natural one node compound? They simply pass one spade. Remember, they don't have a game on opposite 11-15. We could just read what I'll write. He knows everything. Read. Also played by Cornell and off Denmark.
Yeah, it's a tempting setup. The slam is better than a finesse. Finesse in spades will do it, but if the defense don't take their ace of hearts at trick one, they won't get it. It's the sort of hand where relayers resolve the problem because they find out that they're off a key ace and a king, and they just stay out. That
Mom, decent contract here.
Did well, but, Richard. It's not exactly that many hikes.
So West opened a mini no trump, North doubled. East jumped to three diamonds. South passed. Four diamonds by West. And North was pretty much forced into bidding five clubs. And that won't happen here.
No. The Dutch arrived at two clubs. Now they're going to arrive at, well, I don't know. Now the auction's going to get pushed up a bit. Really? East passed two hands?
Well, the vice can't really bid more, can he? He's looking at three certain losers and maybe a club loser also. Partner who couldn't bid over two clubs. So it was a little lucky for Sweden, one has to say, because they were pushed to five clubs in the other group. I mean, North had no choice over four diamonds. He hadn't shown his hand yet.
Yes, I now understand East's silence here. Of course, he was opposite a past partner. So he's very nervous with his very flat hand about the opponents getting to some contract, making contract, a high making contract. So he didn't push it, even though he had six excellent diamonds there. That was very nicely thought through.
And how good is five clubs, by the way?
Oh, it's got its chances. It's got three positions, two of which have to be right, aren't they? The spade finesse, the heart position, and the club position. And two of them were right, the hearts and the clubs.
Yeah.
So it's fair. Makes sometimes, goes down sometimes.
Yes. True. For say the king of clubs of spades had been on side. Queen, king, ace. Then you would need something very good to happen in hearts.
No, just the jack of hearts on side, for example. Or the clubs. I mean, if the spade finesse works, you've got a lot of chances here. The one that Trump show, was it like one of the mini ones, was it? Like 9 to 11 or something?
Yes, I think 9 to 12, but I'm not quite sure. You see, I was right for once, it was 9-12.
Sounds a bit of a three things to go right in four spades. Finesse, heart finesse, the club finesse. More or less. With some variations, and indeed two of them are right, the heart's on side and the club's on side. Oh, I beg your pardon, no, the club isn't on side.
England and Italy both bid and made six diamonds on 27, but England virtually out of it now. They're only one imp away from zero VPs at the moment. 60-1 in imps. Just as well that this is over soon, the bill. Be not prepared to think. Don't want to do England anymore.
Well, it's incredibly surprising. I mean, the English team's better. I know a whisk away from the bowl last year. So yeah. To get wiped out, 60 imps, that's unusual.
Very. It's after 10 boards. And France ruining the excitement at the very top. They're currently ahead by 25 VPs. So obviously if they are 21 VPs ahead before the last round, they can't be caught, or just 20 point something. My guess is that they will choose Netherlands against Poland as the voice match, the BBO one match for the last round, but it's only a guess. No other obvious matches, maybe in the last round now. Well, we have England-France, of course. Do you think they're going to show that? Maybe they are, because France will likely win the gold medal.
Well, I don't think they should. That'd be my view. I don't think you should show a match despite it being the leaders, who've been on plenty of Eurographs, that has absolutely no bearing on the qualification for the Bermuda Bowl. I wouldn't choose that match.
So you would go for Netherlands-Poland, where Poland has something to play for?
Yeah, sure. That's second versus eighth or ninth or whatever. Any of the teams sitting sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, any of their matches might be worth showing. Who does Italy play in the last round? Roland, do you know?
Say that again. Did you say Israel?
No, sorry, I was asking who Italy play in the last.
Oh, I can look it up. One second. Bulgaria may show that one.
That's on the edge.
Yeah. Netherlands, Poland. Remember, they should also choose France against Netherlands in the women's, shouldn't they? And I'm sure they will. Norway-Monaco, also possible, of course. Norway-Monaco, yes, of course, especially Norway-Monaco, with three Norwegian pairs playing against one pair from France/Poland. Sorry, I couldn't resist.
Well, I like the Italy-Bulgaria match because they're both teams that are not certain to qualify, so it's like a head-to-head encounter.
Right. Now, I can't believe Italy is on the air. Coming by us, but six are not. So, they wouldn't have been where they are if they had Bocchi, Madala, and Dubois and partner play. That's for sure.
Here's a question for you, Roland. The qualifying teams are not necessarily, would they necessarily have the same personnel when they rock up to the 2017 Bermuda Bowl? I guess that's a country by country thing, but what's the general approach there? Because it's a long separation between the qualifying events and the actual event over a year.
It depends where in the world you are, or where in Europe you are. It would be normal to have trials again. I mean, so the team that qualified, the players on that team are not certain of going to the Bermuda Bowl. But in some countries, they'll say, well, they took us to the Bermuda Bowl, they deserve to represent us again. So it very much depends on the country. But there's no law, of course, no rule. You don't have to field the same team.
I think this contract's going to be pretty comfortable, and Declare is probably going to lose a trick in each suit. I think he's going to get to dummy and play a heart up towards the king.
Well, I knew I would get this question starting. It's because they, for a long, long, long time, Mrs. Lavazza selected her team, the team, but not so anymore. Now the Federation has taken over and they arrange team trials. Then you could argue, well, those six players could be on the same team. They could, yeah. But they don't have the same sponsor, you see. So that's a problem. Mrs. Lavazza is a sponsor of one team, and Mr. Angelini is a sponsor of another team. So that's how it works in Italy now. But, you know, he wrote something a couple of weeks ago. He said, well, Of course I would have liked to play, but wasn't to be, so I wish the Italian team the best of luck. That's the spirit. France will probably for the last round. The last two of the season in 2000, it was the old VP scale then, the 25-0 scale, or 25-5 if you like. And they were 59 VPs ahead of second place team with two rounds to go.
Here's a worthy hand. Three clubs. Not enough with six hearts. A lay down.
Yeah, but again the Dutch didn't get much their way. They doubled them in three clubs.
Cease must have been a little nervous about doubling three clubs for takeout, obviously. The partner would pass on an unsatisfactory hand. And so it turned out. Well, let's see what happens. We're in exactly the same position.
Yeah, we are. And why wouldn't he pass? At love all? I think he will. The alternative is, of course, three hearts, but I think he passes.
Brie Love is not upon a trump. So I'll play it. Thank you very much.
Give me hearts instead.
You're no fun.
No, I'm not.
It's still a very good slam, of course. I mean, you could take it, you know, as one of the diamonds. If the worst comes to the worst and you can't rough all your losers in the West hand, you could at least take a couple of diamond finesses.
Well, this is not too bad for Declara, actually, despite the 5-0 trump break. He has a side suit he can work on. Partner has three little spades. He has no guess in diamonds. It's not really bad. Quite normal setup here. Your sight suit, very good rule. Obviously, if you can draw trumps, you can draw the trumps first. Here you know you can't, because you're doubled. So go for your side suit.
Now in England rough. Or a spade rough.
Yeah. It's all about, I suppose, is it just 20 for north-south? Look. 220, where do we see 220? Can't be board 21. No adjustment. Maybe it's not this match. Probably not. Does that mean that if we double own it? It's North rough. Then he has to play a diamond. In which case they can still take a look. How do you suggest, Bill, that he gets out for one down?
Well, yes, if he plays a heart and north roughs it and plays a diamond, that's the ace. And then and he plays, gives the partner a diamond rough.
Spade,
getting into a position where he's end played, so he has to play a heart and declare a roughs it. Now West is down to all clubs, so he's going to have to lead away from his queen and declare he's still got ace king X, something like that. Anyway, let's see what happens.
Oh, I see. So if he plays a diamond now, and East goes up with the ace, then comes the spade rough. And then West will either have to play a heart where dummy can rough, or away from the queen of clubs. I see that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Can he do the same now?
Yeah. Well, he will. He's going to rough this, and he'll have to play a club.
Yeah. But now the jack of diamonds is not set up. Did he need to play the jack?
Yeah, he might have needed to play the jack there. Yeah.
Well, still tough for West to get it down, I'd say. It has to be a middle crop, right? It's a forcing declarer to win with a jack. If he plays a low club, the 8 will take the trick.
That's right, and then a winning spade. And then West Ruffs, he has the choice of either giving dummy a half ruff or playing a trump, in which case declarer draws trumps. And cashes the last spade. So it has to be the middle club to force dummy to win the jack and have a losing diamond to play.
Yeah.
Now diamond to a lope with the, okay, nope.
Mm-hmm. End play. Dear, dear. Pretty.
Funny way to score 5 imps, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Great. But it was a defensive error, one has to say. Rang had to shorten his partner's trump holding with a spade rock. Okay. 2 boards to go. Now in 7th, but they're both not the VP starting qualification medal, that's for sure. One club strong, one diamond weak, 0 to 8 I believe they play. Here's one of Al's 5,000 macros. Amazing.
Yeah, I don't get this. If Western won.
That might not have been natural, Bill. Let me look.
Obviously, it's neither here nor there on this hand, but trade interference doesn't seem as effective as an immediate interference.
He could have bid a natural 2 club. So England finally, on the, well, they had won it. But they're getting going down in 6 yards on 30. Hanging out. But I don't think it'll be enough for England. And remember, they had to play France in the last round. They may be too far behind anyway. We shall see.
I think they're too far behind. I think they and Ireland are out in this round.
Yes, you would also want to finish in the top 10, though, which would qualify for the European Champions Cup. I believe it's in November, where the national team champions from the ten nations plus the defending champions plus the host nation, 12 teams, will play for that championship. And sometimes it has happened. It happened last year, actually, where Italy was the defending champion and they hosted the event and such stuff, and they would be fielding two teams.
Last board, and the 5 club contract. Anyway, thank you all for coming along to watch this pretty tight match, and thank you, Roland, for your sterling effort. I think you've done a whole lot of commentary this week and done it very well. Thanks also to our written commentators. Al and Marku, at least I know of, and our excellent operator, who I never noticed, so she must have done a fantastic job, Laura S. Ersek, and to the organisers for putting on the Europeans onto BBO, and BBO for providing the platform. Who else have I missed out on? I think that's basically it, and the final round, the final exciting round, is due to start in just under half an hour.
Yeah. I still don't have our matches, I'm afraid. So they're not deciding. Well, they might have decided right now at this very moment, but I still don't have anything in my box. Doesn't really matter regarding voice, because our two assigned commentators, Peter and Graham, will go to BBO. So will you be retiring, Bill? Yeah, I understand it. Sure. So I'll just give it a miss, and that's fine. Then I won't hit 30. I'll stop with 29 sessions. Will bore 21 be adjusted? I don't know with 21. What is the issue?
Yes, I don't know. I mean, it was a fascinating contract. This is the one where there was apparently a misplay in the other room, which wasn't.
Oh.
Trump contract.
I'm told that the director was called regarding alleged misinformation. I see. I didn't know that. So whether they'll adjust it or not, we don't know. But surely, they should actually make a ruling before the start of the last round, shouldn't they? So people know where they are. Well, doesn't that make a difference? Maybe not.
Oh, I think it's very normal to hear all appeals prior to the start of the final round, so that the appeals committee is unaware of what impact their decision might have. This is the auction where there was what we thought was a Muppet Stamen auction, so Tino Trump's three clubs, three hearts denying a four or five card major. Now, West found what was a perhaps an unlikely lead of the King of Diamonds from King Queen Fourth. So maybe he felt that he was misinformed about this auction. Maybe he got a different explanation from his screen mate, South.
Hmm. Could be. You're right. All right, we shall see. It's now a fact that England is out of it. They lost on that five club hand. Italy in five clubs and four hearts down one at the other table. Oh, I've got our matches for the last round, actually. But since Bill is going to bed, and I can understand him, it's not really important. You'll see the six matches in due course.
Well, what's the featured match, Roland?
Netherlands, Poland, Monaco, Norway, Bulgaria, Italy, Greece, Hungary. The featured match, BBO 1 match, let me see. Netherlands, Poland. That's a good one. Monaco, Norway will attract many, many spectators. No doubt about it. Bulgaria, Italy. Greece, Hungary. We always have Hungary because we have Hungarian commentators commentating in Hungarian to a cafe, I think it is, somewhere in Budapest, on a giant screen. Right. Yep, Al will be watching Belarus against Cyprus. Thank you, Al. We need one for that match.
Well, I'm sure he'll have both their systems in front of him. So one final imp for four clubs, which I think is probably the right result. There seem to be three losers there, stayed in the club.
We also have two matches from the women's, England, Poland, and Sweden, Italy, I think it is. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, everyone, and goodbye for now.
Cheerio.